I've talked about the good. I've covered my favorite products of this of 2018, and that's generally what I focus on in my videos. I want to focus on positivity, cool things that you should check out. And a lot of times there's products that I just downright either just have a horrible time with or just absolutely hate, and I don't get around to covering them. That's what this video is dedicated to. The top 5 products that are just my biggest disappointment or the worst products that I've ever checked out this year. Let's jump in.
Remember is a simple, secure, and beautifully designed password manager that stores your logins and saves you time. It has a strong password generator, secure backups, cross-device syncing for unlimited devices and passwords, and their plans are insanely affordable. You can get 3 years for just $63. That's less than $2 per month this holiday season. Learn more with the link in the video description.
The point of this video is not to pick on or harp on one specific product any too much, but these are things that either I've just had a very bad time with myself, even if it's my own fault, or just were a huge disappointment compared to what I expected. And it's just how tech works. It's just what happens sometimes. And we're gonna start out, again, these are in no particular order. We're gonna start out with maybe the obvious one, because I literally titled it the worst product I've ever reviewed, the Turtle Beach microphone. That thing was something that I did not have high expectations from. I didn't expect it to be this big, amazing product, but I expected it to be a competent USB microphone, especially since they had so many like professional, well not professional, but like full-time live streamers who were using ElectroVoice RE320 microphones and crazy setups like that, and they paid them to do a campaign streaming with this Turtle Beach mic and to push it on people. And then it turned out to be like barely functional as a microphone in the first place for live streaming. It was so bad. It was so bad quality. It was, I would argue that it should barely be sold. And I realize I've so much burned a bridge with Turtle Beach, but that's what they get for releasing that microphone into the wild. The next one, which may confuse some of you because I'm actually, at the time of recording, in the process of trying to sell these, are my Rokinon Cine DS Prime lenses. It's a portrait lens bundle that I bought for the Micro Four Thirds mount. Now, the lenses themselves are not bad. These are actually really immensely high quality lenses. I highly recommend checking them out on the whole. And the whole reason I'm trying to sell them is because I want to rebuy them in the Canon EF mount. My mistake was I purchased them for the Micro Four Thirds mount, which I thought I was sticking with for my Panasonic G7. I thought my upgrade path would be the GH5 and that'd be all fine and dandy. I ended up switching mounts, and instead of being a smart person who bought a Canon EF lens set and then a speed booster, I bought them natively mounted. There's no real way to go back from Micro Four Thirds up to EF mount because EF mounts are virtually always bigger sensors. Micro Four Thirds is a crop sensor. There's just nothing that will do it that I have ever found. And there is something with the way that they've adapted the lenses for the smaller crop factor mount that the minimum focusing distance for these lenses are really far away compared to other lenses that I've used of even the same focal length. And so in my tiny, you know, shooting spaces, this makes them very difficult to shoot with on the Panasonic G7. So again, I'm trying to sell these lenses and I would love to buy the exact same kit again in EF mount, and I've even sent an email to Rokinon saying, hey, is there any way I could just exchange these? They're brand new, I only used them once, for an EF mount, even if I have to just pay a little bit more for the upgrade. Like, is that a thing? Haven't heard back yet, but a big disappointment and mistake for me. And if you're using them, I highly recommend not getting them in Micro Four Thirds mount and instead buying them in EF mount, because even that with the speed booster would mean you get a closer focusing distance than I can get right now with them. Let's cover one more microphone here, and that is the Heil PR40. This thing is a legendary microphone. People recommend it all the time. I even had Mike Russell over at Music Radio Creative do a response video to my video on it, because that video was more of an industry response to everyone saying it was the best, and then I get it, and I was very disappointed in it. And I understand why it sounds the way that it does, but both the out-of-box sound and the slight tweaking I tried to do with post-processing, like, it just sounded so hollow. I have had people say who don't have super high or super low end voices that are kind of in the middle range, that it's one of the few mics they found that they could actually make themselves sound good, but I was just disappointed. That being said, again, lots of people love it. I'm also trying to sell this kit because I used it once and I need it gone. Speaking of bad purchases, oh man, one of the biggest wastes of money that I super regret this year has been the Edelkrone Slider 1 Pro motorized slider kit. Now, their marketing is more geared towards time lapses and things like that these days, which is fine, but I saw it recommended a few times and some pretty glowing endorsements of it for video slider shots. And I have been looking for an automated and motorized slider system for a very long time just because I suck with a slider, and it would be really cool when I'm working and doing stuff to have a slider that just kind of goes back and forth behind me or next to me or something while I'm doing something and getting those really cool shots. This wasn't it. It took so long for my order to come in because part of my order apparently contained a pre-order for something little that I didn't care about. The motion box attachment, which is more time-lapse oriented anyway, but it can barely turn even my Panasonic G7, which weighs nothing. The motor in it is just garbage. They sent out an email after I already got mine saying you had a couple weeks if you wanted to get their new upgraded motor to send it in, which by the time I saw the email, it was already passed, and so I was just stuck with it. They don't have any controls on the tools themselves, and so you have to take the battery out of the slider itself, or it will just die by the time you use it next, and you just basically have to keep the motion box on a slider, or on a power charger, because they just kind of stay even in airplane mode, and it's just, and I had, the app was terrible, it was so unreliable, I couldn't get steady slides with it to save my life, even again, with a light camera, it was just awful. It's probably really great for time lapses, and people with more experience can probably get more out of it. But for me, that was honestly one of the biggest wastes of money I've made in a very long time. So I've got one more main product of something that I was reviewing that I want to talk about, but then I'm going to throw in a little extra one because screw it, why not? First, we have the newer green screen. Oh, that was a fun endeavor. If you haven't seen the original videos, I highly recommend going and checking them out. This was a knockoff or competitor to the Elgato green screen. It is a green screen stand-up chroma key background with the little sliding mechanism so it stands up behind you if you don't have a wall, portable, but it was taller. And that appealed to me since I'm a tall person. The Elgato green screen isn't quite tall enough to use without putting it on top of something while I'm standing. And I just wanted to review a competitor. The first one I bought completely, it seemed to have, like the shipping box itself seemed to be in fine condition, but it fell apart on my second use. Like I left it standing, walked downstairs for a second, came back and the whole thing was just destroyed. And then they sent me a second one and it seemed all right, but there were still some quirks and it still clearly wasn't gonna last very long. There were still some parts that weren't how it was supposed to be. And then they eventually removed the green screen from Amazon entirely as far as I can tell, which is just freaking hilarious. It was a great saga. I recommend going and checking out those videos. I also wanted to throw in a product that it works for my purpose and you guys ask about it a lot, but it is not worth the money in the slightest, and that is the Lemetric Time. It is the sub counter that you see in the background of my videos above my monitor. It is full price. I got it on sale, but full price it is $200 for this little digital clock. Really terrible Bluetooth speaker. The build quality, the plastic quality is terrible. The Wi-Fi connection is completely unreliable, and they give no thought whatsoever to mounting it or setting it up anywhere. It doesn't even have proper feet on it. It has no mounting options. The charger port is on the back, and so you have to buy a special like right angle connector if you want it up on a wall, and then you have to have your own way of doing it. Just not worth it in the slightest, but for my purposes, it's kind of neat. And then we want to talk about the ultimate disappointment of 2018. That would be Windows 10 1809, which for real is still not even fully released to anyone yet. But you can watch all of my videos on that for more, because I'm all out of talking about it at this point. There's a lot of good products, a lot of tech that I'm excited for, but sometimes it's good to reminisce on the products that were just the worst this year. And that's what this video was. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more tech education. If you want to watch the referenced videos for the products that I did make videos on, links in the description along with product links if you want to torture yourself with these yourself. And again, a couple of these I am selling because for some people they are the right choice. Like I said, hit the like button if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more tech education. I'm EposVox. I'll see you later.